that poverty is not only killing the people in our communities, it is the only, it's not even, it's actually wiped out a whole generation. And what my understanding is that poverty isn't just killing the people in Britain. Poverty is actually costing us all the earth.
Yo, D, what? Come on, what? Come on.
Give me the fortune, keep the fame, said my man Lewis. I agreed, know what he mean, because we lived the truest lie. I asked him why we follow the law of the bluest eye. He looked at me, he thought about it, was like I'm clueless. Why? The question was rhetorical, the answer is horrible. Our morals are out of place, it got a lot full of sorrow. And so tomorrow coming later than usual, waiting on someone to pity us. While we find the beauty in the hideous. They say money's the root of all evil, but I can't tell, you know what I mean? Pesos, franc shens, carry shells, dollar bills. Or is it the mind state that's ill, creating crime rates to fill the new prisons they build.
To tackle climate change without tackling the issues of poverty would alienate so many people who are already on the fringes and so badly oppressed, and that if we are ever to build a broad enough based movement to do anything substantial about climate change, it will need to be encompassing the poor, but in the broadest possible sense.
One of the exercises that we continually blame politicians for their own inadequacies, the same people themselves actually had a look to see, rather than blame the politicians for any impact that we as human beings are having on the climate. And I don't mean switch off your lights for half an hour or 10 minutes or things like that. Start to look at it in general as a group, as a community. Do you see how it's going to affect you and your future children and your grandchildren?
I'm here today because it's really exciting to see people fighting poverty and fighting climate change and environmental problems come together and share their issues and concerns, because the last thing companies like British Airways, companies like E.ON, who are perpetuating poverty and perpetuating climate change, want to see happen is everyone make the connections and join the dots between the impacts of these companies' actions. All that people have heard is talk, talk, talk from the local councils, from the government, about taking action on the big issues of our time, such as poverty and environmental issues. And all we've seen is talk and no action. So people are saying, actually, you know what? We can get together, we can do things ourselves, and we are gonna take the action necessary to stop all the problems that are going on. So over the next year, I reckon we'll see a lot of things happening, and we'll see a lot of these companies brought to account and say that actually you can't continue making people's lives a misery anymore by people having to choose between putting food on the table or heating up their homes, or living by a polluted industry which they never asked for in the first place. So I think enough's enough, and people are starting to get together, and we're gonna see a lot of excitement over the next year, so get involved.
Hiding like thieves in the night from life, illusions of oasis, making you look twice. Hiding like thieves in the night from life, illusions of oasis, making you look twice. Hiding like thieves in the night from life, illusions of oasis, making you look twice. Hiding like thieves in the night from life, illusions of oasis, making you look twice. Stop hiding.